Recently, a friend of mine asked me to propose a synthesis for a chemical called niacin. As a hobbyist chemist who wears a lab coat in front of a computer just to feel like I'm more competent than I actually am, I obviously gave it a try. It was pretty boring though, so I sort of shrugged it off. But then, I realized that niacin looked pretty familiar. After a couple minutes, I managed to recall that a chemical it was similar to. Nicotine. Nicotine happens to be very structurally similar to niacin, and since I was looking for a fun synthesis challenge, I decided that a theoretical synthesis of nicotine from niacin would be a great idea. Now, this is interesting for a multitude of reasons. First of all, there aren't that many nicotine syntheses, simply because nicotine naturally appears in the tobacco plant, so nobody ever had to make it synthetically. This makes me unable to cheat that easily, which is good. Secondly, I really doubt that one of these syntheses would be from niacin, which is literally one of the three molecules that can be titled vitamin B3. I would probably be the first person to think of a synthesis of nicotine from a vitamin, so I got to work. But before I present you the finished synthesis, a couple disclaimers. Number one, nicotine is a very addictive substance. Number two, if you're watching this thinking you can make nicotine from the vitamin gummies you bought at a pharmacy store, well, you can, but that's just inefficient, and buying actual nicotine would save you lots of money. Number three, as I mentioned before, I'm only a hobbyist chemist and do not have a degree. This means that I could have overlooked a lot of important things, and you should consult with an actual chemist if you want to do this. Alright, let's get into it. The synthesis begins with decarboxylation of niacin into pyridine. This is done by refluxing niacin for about an hour with copper chromide as a catalyst. Then, we perform halogenation of pyridine by means of bromine with indium chloride as a catalyst. This reaction is optimally carried out at a temperature of around 100 degrees Celsius. After that, we substitute the bromine with a dihydroxyborane group by applying triisopropyl borate together with N-butyl lithium and hydrochloric acid. The next reaction uses a substance called 2-chloro-1-methylpyrrole, which is not that accessible, but can be easily obtained from 1-methylpyrrole. We perform the Friedel-Crafts reaction with chlorine at a temperature of around 50 degrees Celsius to obtain 2-chloro-1-methylpyrrole, with ferrous chloride as a catalyst. I'm pretty sure that alternatively, one can use the much cheaper aluminum trichloride as a catalyst, but I put ferrous chloride there just to be sure. Back to the main synthesis. We perform a Suzuki-Miura coupling reaction with 2-chloro-1-methylpyrrole, tetracis, triphenylphosphine palladium, sodium carbonate, and benzene in order to obtain a nicotine precursor. Now, to finish off the synthesis, a hydrogenation is done with palladium on a carbon as a catalyst. This catalyst ensures that the bonds of the upper ring will be hydrogenated first. The bottom ring will also be hydrogenated, but that happens even up to 15 hours after starting the hydrogenation process. And that's about it. We have obtained nicotine. Thank you for watching the synthesis, and feel free to leave your comments down below. You can also reach out to me on Discord. My nick and tag should be in my channel info. See ya.